Hi, this is Freddy from Switzerland with another knife review, and today I have a very, very interesting in-depth look at a new knife maker out of the US for you prepared. I also did a first impressions and unboxing video of this particular knife, and you can check that out here in the top right corner. The knife and knife maker we are talking about today is Jason Van Camp and his company VC Edge out of California. And his first model that he ever has done, and that is the VC Edge interface. You can see the knife right here. Very impressive from the get-go. Very, very interesting as well. And I have this knife now for almost a month, and I'm super, super impressed with what he actually achieved here and the way that he has done it. I think Jason Van Camp could be the next Sharp by Design Brian Nadeau, just in a more focused, lightweight kind of knife making. The CNC machine work that is done here, also the hand grinding of the blades, all the technical intricacies, the detent system that he has, the way he redesigned the lock bar to conform with laws in terms of the subframe lock controversy, and everything that is done here on this knife in the way that it is done just shows me that he's an absolute master CNC machinist, and that he has a certain view of the knife and his quality standards that is just very hard to match in today's world. So I really think that his stuff will become very, very popular very, very fast, and that's why I wanted to give you this full in-depth look just right now, so you can get on his books and snag one of his knives as long as they are still available and attainable. So very, very highly recommended maker by me, and you will see why during this review. Also, you can follow Jason Van Camp at JasonVC on Instagram. Everything will be linked in the description below. He also has the website vcedgeknives.com, and he has actually a YouTube channel where he shows the designing, building, and everything he does with the knives, the hand finishing, hand grinding, and all the theories and thoughts behind these knives. So very, very impressive stuff that he shares, all of that, and a very, very fun channel to take a look at to see how these CNC machine knives are built and how he has thought them through and what the important things to him are in building these knives. This knife right here is model 22, so we are very early on, and he is only building very few knives in batches, so it's very hard to get these knives. They always sell out pretty fast, but I think that will only accelerate because his stuff is so well done. I think at the moment we are at model 35 of knives that he built on this new version of the interface, which is his first model. And I also have one correction to make on my original unboxing video. He was actually a manufacturing engineer in the aerospace industry and not an aerospace engineer. I don't really know what's the difference there, but he wanted me to correct that. Also, contact him on Instagram. He's a very great guy to talk to, very knowledgeable about a lot of different things, and he's a very approachable maker, which is always great to see, especially in newer makers. Just shows you the potential that they have to become big. And I really liked talking with him about the knives and the process in which he builds them. So now that we have all that out of the way, let's take a look at the specs of the VC Edge interface. We have an overall length of 8.45 inches or 21.4 centimeters with a blade length of 3.6 inches or 9.1 centimeters. Pretty thick blade stock because it's made from mostly carbon fiber right here of 4.8 millimeters. And then we have a S35VN cutting edge insert that runs about this height of the blade. You will see an inlaid picture there inset into the carbon fiber blade. We also have the VC Edge logo and the S35 designature in this nicely inlaid titanium placket right there. Then we have a handle length of 4.8 inches or 12.3 centimeters. And the most impressive thing about this almost eight and a half inch blade is the weight. You already have noticed that it's almost completely made out of carbon fiber, a little bit of steel for the cutting edge, a little bit of titanium for the two-piece integral frame lock clip and backspacer. Then we have a stainless steel stop pin right there, custom ceramic bearings, custom multi-row ceramic bearings, and also titanium hardware. And this weighs just 1.73 ounces or 49 grams. For a knife of this size, this is absolutely unheard of, and one of the most impressive things that this guy has actually achieved on this knife, together with the amazing action we are going to talk to a little bit later in the video. And while achieving a weight that is insanely low, he still managed to make this knife feeling super solid, no wiggle, no flex, nothing like that. It's a super solid, amazingly smooth, great action sporting folder with an insanely lightweight, coupled with a very usable, pretty large cutting edge and blade. So that is just absolutely insane. Just to put this into perspective, this knife at almost 8.5 inches is a bit lighter than a full-sized Benchmade Bugout. This is an extremely light knife that has been touted for that fact, but it's much, much smaller than the VCH interface, and a knife that is just 3 grams lighter, so almost the same weight as the VCH interface, is the Kershaw Launch 9. So you can see here the difference that this makes. This is an almost insane achievement on part of this knife. So these two knives weigh almost the same, and that is just incomprehensible to me. So he really has achieved something out of this world with that weight, and the way he has done it makes this knife absolutely impressive, because it feels so solid. The action is insane, especially if you keep in mind that this blade almost weighs nothing, which is absolutely amazing, because normally the blade relies on some kind of inertia and weight of the blade. Heavier blades fall nicer into the handle, heavier blades deploy a bit better because of the weight they have when they break the detent, and he has had to work past all of this to achieve the action that he has on this knife and the strength that it sports. Also, one last thing about the weight, this knife is also heavier. This is a very small carbon fiber and G10 handle Spyderco Reinhold Rhino, and this is quite a bit heavier than this knife. So now that you have that out of the way, which is one of the most impressive things I have seen in knife making in a couple of years now, so this really is a new beast in terms of knife making. This really is, for people that are concerned about weight, pretty much the holy grail of knife making. But coupled with that, he has a lot of different things that really impress us as well. For example, the overall fit and finish and machining on the carbon fiber handle here. We have this great line texturing that is nice and nice feeling, and actually giving you some traction here when holding the knife. We have a very nicely machined, actually skeletonized and floating backspacer with the model name and number engraved into it. We have this very well executed two-piece frame lock design that is bonded to the carbon fiber pretty much seamlessly. We have the gorgeous milling continuing on the titanium as well as on the pocket clip, which is just so well done. And you maybe have noticed, but the pocket clip is actually reversible. You almost can't see it, but you can actually reverse the pocket clip. That's why you have these two holes here. So you can reverse the pocket clip to tip up right or left side carry, and the pocket clip actually works very well, even though it's a short 3D milled clip. You can also see that he took out some weight there on both sides. So he really looked at every micro ounce on this knife to make it as lightweight, but still as solid as possible. It's certainly a stiffer clip than something long and springy, but it worked on all of my pans pretty much flawlessly. And because it's so small, it doesn't provide any kind of hotspot. The ergonomics on this knife are very, very well done. It's not super skinny, so you still have a good hand feeling thickness in the hand. You can put your thumb up here on the blade because it's a little bit of thicker blade stock in terms of the carbon fiber used. And in the hand, it feels very solid. You can do a lot of work with. The lockup is nice and solid. Of course, you have a stainless steel lock bar insert. And the detent that he uses is actually machined into that insert. I really tried to show you that here with a flashlight because it's not easy to see. but you can peek in there and see there is no ceramic ball pressed into there. We have a little milled knob in there that actually acts as the detent, and it's also a flat face detent. There is also a lot of skeletonization on the inside right there. And this knob kind of detent system reminds me a bit of the thing that Brian Nadeau has done on his knives. Here you can see also the same kind of knob system, or not the same, but a similar kind. This is not really flat faced, but you can see there's also something milled out of the inlay or into the inlay to provide a great detent. And in the Brian Nadeau, it actually makes for a one click kind of opening sound, which is very different from the from other knives. And here we have also a very unique sound and a super smooth action, but here we have a distinct two click sound. Tac tac, you can certainly hear that. And the action is so impressive, especially if you keep in mind how lightweight that blade is. It's very crisp, pretty loud actually, and it works every time. It's almost impossible not to deploy this blade when you pull on that flipper tab. And how that blade rockets down without having any kind of mass to it is just an impressive feature of the custom bearing system that he uses. He uses a multi-row, in-house designed, full ceramic bearing system on these knives. He also has the detent rack and everything also built from steel, so there's no carbon fiber involved in the pivot area where anything rides alongside each other. And that certainly facilitates this insane action on a super lightweight knife that we have here. Also, centering is perfect. Just the quality that this knife oozes is impressive. This really feels like a knife from the future. I think modern knife making should be done like this. If you take a look, for example, at the titanium pivot, you see this is also made in-house by him. Everything is made in-house by him except the materials. Also, the choice for using a unidirectional carbon fiber for the blade right here, so it gives it like a little bit of a Damascus kind or San Mai kind of feel, is just a great overall choice. You really can see all the hard thought, work, and design process that went into these knives. Just overall, very, very impressive, I have to say. Now let's take a look at some size comparison so you can get a feel for this knife, since this is really an oddball knife and certainly a knife that not a lot of people have already experienced. Another thing before I forget it, this is the certificate of authenticity that you're getting. You can see all the different features that you have chosen. There are also anodized versions, but it cannot already anodize the lock bar, so it's just a clip and the pivot screw. I think maybe also the backspacer that can be anodized. So far, but he probably will offer anodizing on the lock bar as well. That is just because some of the anodizing will take place after it's already bonded to the carbon fiber, and he has to figure out a way how to do a consistent anodizing on the lock bar. And that also shows you that he only will offer things to you as the customer that he's 100% comfortable with in terms of the quality level that he actually can provide to you. So all the things that he look for in a high-end custom knife maker is certainly well done by this guy here, from the things that I have experienced from him. I haven't covered the prices here already, and I will do that now. So this version here, which is just plain titanium S35VN, which at the moment is the only steel that you can choose, but he is already working on M390 variants for the blade insert right there, is costing you $720 direct from the maker. And from what I have experienced with this knife, I think it's 100% worth it. This is the most impressive and most unique knife I have seen in years. This really caught me off guard and will certainly stay in my collection for a very long time. So now let's get to the size comparisons. First off, we have the Shirogorov F95NL at the top and the Shirogorov Neon at the bottom right there, and you can see it's pretty much identical in terms of size and length to the Shiro-Gorov, but incredibly lightweight. Then we have our standard benchmark EDC blades. We have the Para 3 and the Bug Out. Keep in mind, this knife is lighter than both by quite a bit. And you can see it's larger than both. So it's certainly a full-size knife. And in terms of length, at the larger end of knives that I like to carry for EDC. Some other size comparisons here, we have the 0609 by ZT, which is smaller. Then we have my custom Skiff Drifter, which is also smaller. Then some other custom folders, I have is the Simon Stricker's Tour, which is slightly smaller. And then I have the RH Knives Tusker 2, also a custom knife maker, a newer custom knife maker. This one is from the Czech Republic. Check out the video on that guy. And you can see it's larger than most of the knives I have shown you and still lighter than all of them. So that certainly should show you how much of an achievement it is to make it that lightweight and still solid and with an action that is just unheard of for a knife of this weight. So overall, I hope you could feel the excitement I have for this knife. The VC Edge interface by Jason Van Camp is already my knife of 2021. I can't imagine a knife that could come out this year that would dethrone this knife. This is everything I think modern knife making should be. It's the perfect implementation of materials for the things that they can do best. I really look forward to seeing what this guy comes up with next. I would love to see a smaller knife with everything included that he has done in here, just to have it a little bit shorter in terms of EDC carryability. But what he has done here is so impressive overall that I think everybody needs to take a hard look at this guy. If you're into custom knives, if you're into CNC machine knives, you need to have one of these knives in your collection. This marks a point of perfection and attention to detail in CNC based custom knife making that I haven't seen from any other maker. And doing something at this level of quality and design perfection at your first folder just shows you that Mr. Van Camp can go the extra mile and that he will be one of the greats in my estimation. So I hope you could feel the excitement and the appreciation I have for this knife. And I really recommend to check out his website and his Instagram as well as his YouTube channel. You can find everything linked down below. And if you have the chance, go grab one of his knives once he drops some more. I think at the moment everything is sold out, but he will be regularly dropping interfaces on his website. So thank you for watching. Have a nice day and goodbye.